two.
That's one.
This is Egan AM.
This week on Egan AM, out and about,
haunted house,
and the wildcat world of sports.
All right, hey, welcome back to another episode. This week we got a little Halloween special for you guys. And speaking of something scary, how about facing that Wildcat defense on a third down? Truly a phenomenal game, but more on that later.
Now here's over to Tate with a special out-of-state episode of Out and About.
For the first episode of Out and About, we traveled to New York City to ask New Yorkers some questions. First off, boxers or briefs?
I mean, I wear boxer briefs. That's like literally what they are. They're like the shape of boxers, but they're briefs.
Oh, you gotta go with briefs, man.
Briefs, I agree.
Sorry?
Boxers or briefs?
I don't understand, I'm from Europe.
Boxers?
Whatever floats your boat or whatever lets it hang.
Boxers.
To become one of my favorite stand-up comics of all time and a good friend. Please welcome the hilarious Preacher Lawson.
Preacher Lawson!
Boxers or briefs, in your opinion?
Boxers, bro. Wait. Boxers, are those briefs are the ones that hug you, right?
Yeah.
Well, briefs then, yeah, man.
Does it feel loose or 12-year-old?
It feels great, man. Everybody should try it out. You know, losing $1 million to a 12-year-old is the best feeling ever.
What do you think about left-handed people?
Woo!
Damn. They're just a right-sided people.
Yeah, do you think they're evil?
Could be.
I don't know.
No, you don't think so?
I don't know.
Okay. What's your take on garden gnomes?
It depends on, like, the theme, I guess.
And what's your take on garden gnomes? In your opinion, is a hot dog a sandwich?
No.
Why is that?
Because a sandwich has slices of bread over a wider area.
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
In some cultures, yes.
In your culture?
No.
Hot dog?
Yeah, do you think it's a hot dog or do you think it's a sandwich?
Hot dog? It's more like a hero.
No, it's not a hero. So
sandwich.
Sandwich.
You think it's a sandwich?
No, I like sandwich.
Oh, you like? What do you think of people in my generation, high schoolers nowadays?
I don't know. You guys are either like really on it or really stupid.
Yeah, that's accurate. All right.
I look at you guys as the future. I'm 21. You know, I'm the future now.
Just like be on your. Don't be dumb.
All right. Thank you so much.
Awesome.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
No
it was
problem.
Nice to meet you.
All right. Good luck.
Appreciate it.
Have a good one, man.
You too.
You are.
Go ahead and explain your story.
Oh, so I'm black my whole life. It's been the whole time. I didn't switch it up. I'm not even black. Check this out.
This Friday from 5 to 8, Egan is hosting the first ever in-person competitive Smash Bros. Tournament. The tournament is open to any high school student with a $15 entry fee. Spectators can get in free. There's also a $150 prize. Food and drinks will be available for purchase on site. If you aren't able to make it, the tournament will be streamed on Egan Esports YouTube. The event will be hosted in the library, but make sure to come early to get registered. For more information, go to the Egan Esports Instagram or scan the QR codes posted around the school.
Over the MEA break, Pierce, Jayla, and Tim braved a haunted house while reading some spooky facts about the house's history. Here's their trip through the haunted house experience.
We are at the Haunting Experience in Cottage Grove, Minnesota.
Dude, chill.
Yeah, Cottage Grove. We are at the Haunted Experience today. We're gonna give you a brief history about what this is and, just some fun facts about the Haunted Experience that runs all the way through Halloween. But there's a twist. We're going to walk through the haunted house while giving you the history.
I don't wanna do this.
Come on.
I don't either. It's the premier go-to for Halloween scares in the Twin Cities. They recommend 12 years and up.
Come on.
Who is 12 going to this haunted house?
What the f-? They recommend 12 and up for this house, okay? With a legacy of terror of over 30 years, the Haunting Experience on Highway 61 is the premier go-to for Halloween scares in the Twin Cities. They have a hair-raising haunted house and the oldest haunted hayride here in Minnesota.
They do.
Oh, God! So here at the haunted house, located in Cottage Grove. The whole experience includes... Shut up, Jayla. The whole experience includes choices for you. You will get your haunting experience ticket punched twice if you choose once.
Hi, Jayla! Come stay with us, Jayla!
They follow CDC guidelines.
Yes, they follow.
Talking about masks and stuff.
If you feel ill, please stay at home.
Holy God.
We do use strobe lights in the haunted house.
These scare actors have been working since the start, and they closed the day after. Hi. You're able to just have concessions if you would like.
You are intoxicated, being aggressive, or hostile. We reserve the right to remove you from premises. Why is she walking with us?
She's going for a stroll.
She got a speed walk going on.
They're everywhere. And,
I smell some fresh meat!
Wait,
right here. He's right here. That's the meat.
No.
I'm not. I think you're next. You want to get in the box?
No!
Are you sure?
No!
What
the f***?
So, yeah, we did it. Thank you, Egan, AM. This was worth it. And you know what they always say, hide your kids, hide your wives.
And hide your husbands, because everybody's out here.
If you want to get scared, definitely come here.
I had a great time. I don't know what Pierce is talking about. What's not to love? Please come down and give the haunted experience you guys the support.
Hey, I don't get scared that easily, but that haunted house might take me down. This event is in Cottage Grove and is open every night from 7 to 11 p.m. and closes on October 31st.
The weather is getting colder and not everyone is as fortunate enough to be able to purchase a warm winter coat. Interact Club just wrapped up their annual coat drive. To everyone who helped out and brought in some warm clothes, we appreciate you. Let's warm up some veterans' hearts by writing some notes. In pause, take some time and write a note thanking them for their service. These notes will be sent out with lots of candy for an extra special treat.
With Halloween just around the corner, we went to the Wabasha Street Caves, a hotspot for paranormal activity. During the spooky season, the caves are open.
My name's Edward Lindham. I've been working at the Wabasha Street Cave since January of this year. We had a group of children here, and they were doing a tour as part of a field trip. And give them a couple ground rules before we bring them back. And when that happened, we saw out of the corner of our eyes, down the hallway, a ghost figure, and he just walked into a wall. And the hallway that we were in, we call it Harry's hallway. He's a very common ghost that we see here, and he's known as being one of our more malicious ghosts. And because we didn't want the children to kind of get freaked out, we kind of shrugged it off, didn't bring any attention to it or anything like that. They noticed a little bit that the tour guide and I were looking down the hall, and they asked about it. We said, it's Harry, it's just a ghost, don't worry about it. And they kind of thought it was funny, and then we continued with the tour, and the rest of the tour went pretty well. Until the end, when we were walking the kids out, and one of the children came up to us and said, I saw Harry at the fountain, and he was wearing an apron, as well as his sleeves were rolled up, and his hands were really dirty, and he didn't look very happy. And this is really interesting to us, because we don't talk about Harry's story on the tour that the children were on, especially because they were children, but Harry was actually buried alive alive in a barrel on property is how the psychics have told his story to us. And so it would make logical sense that his hands would be filthy from trying to climb out and crawl out from the ground underneath. And just the fact that the kid could describe him that fully in a way that matches what all of us tour guides and workers and staff here have seen is a little disconcerting.
The caves are open all year, so this spine-chilling experience doesn't have to end November 1st.
Speaking of spooky stuff, flu season is back. Here are some reminders of simple things you can do to protect yourself and others this winter. Remember to wash your hands before and after eating, touching your face, and of course, after using the restroom. Use hand sanitizer throughout the day, cover your cough with your elbow, and stay home if you're feeling sick. Lastly, make sure to get your flu shot this year. They're available at any pharmacy or at your family's provider office.
Today we have an extra special two-part WCR with Kate out in the stadium preparing for the big playoff football game tomorrow night. Hey Kate, have you picked out your outfit for tomorrow's game?
Yes, I have. As you know, seniors like me wear blue, juniors wear green, and all underclassmen wear white.
Of course, we love to see some school spirit, but what are you doing out there?
Well, we have a big section game tomorrow night right here at Wildcat Stadium, which brings me to the number of the week, which is 2014. For the last time, we had a home section game at Egan. We want to pack the stands, so make sure you buy your tickets beforehand. Tickets are $5 for students. Be sure to come and support the Cats. Now back to Presley in the studio.
Thanks, Kate. Now back to Elias with the rest of WCR.
Great job, Kate. I can't wait to see our boys take another dub. Kicking on the girls' soccer, they had an amazing season, finishing second in their conference and making it to the section championship for the third year in a row. They unfortunately lost to a tough Rosemont team last Tuesday, 4-0. Great job, girls, and congrats on a fantastic season. Moving on over to our boys and girls cross country team. On October 14th, Egan held the Bitter Cold Conference meet just outside EHS. Congrats to sophomore Lila Bartels, who placed third, and sophomore Nora Servant, trailing right behind her, placing fourth, alongside freshman Lauren Borger, who placed 11th. Both our girls and boys teams will be competing today in the section championship. 2 weeks ago, our football team took the win 13-3 at Burnsville. Touchdowns were scored by Carson Schwab and Landon Tonsager. Last Thursday, the boys were able to steal a huge win against number 4-ranked Shakopee. The score is 23-21, with touchdowns by Brooklyn Evans, Landon Tonsager, and Madden Eisen, and a field goal by Jack Hansen that secured the win. Last week, our girls swim and dive took on Prior Lake at home, and they unfortunately lost. However, the girls battled hard and are ready to start sections next week. Top finishers for Egan were Claire Kinzeth, Zara Hickey, Malai Chartier, and Morgan Kipka in the 200-yard medley relay with a time of 2 minutes and 5 seconds. And congrats to freshman Kasan Lee in tennis for winning the singles section tournament last Monday. She will compete this Thursday and Friday at the state tournament at the U. Good luck, Kasan. Our girls volleyball team played Farmington last week and pushed through the last three sets 3-1 to win on Thursday. They took home the big dub at home versus Eden Prairie. First game of sections was Tuesday night against Apple Valley, and they play tonight against Rosemount. And the theme is Minion Out, so get despicable.
What an amazing Halloween episode. If you want to see some behind-the-scenes footage, follow us on Instagram at EganAM. Be safe, make good choices, and have a safe Halloween, everyone.
Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when